So, Juliet and Romeo told me what you did.
You mean what I almost did?
I changed my mind, didn't I?
Lucky me.
Hey, look, I know I have a lot of making up to do. Just let me put out the other fire first before it burns down the house.
Absolutely not a chance. You're gonna tell me right now why you did it. You weren't even gonna say goodbye to me.
I'm constantly being told that I'm a burden on everyone's lives, so I thought, why not put them all out of their misery?
Yeah, well, I don't believe you. Just tell me why you did it. Why would you try and fake your own death?
But I didn't! Did I? I'm still here, scrabbling around in the dirt, trying to... You had that contact, didn't you? When Bruce was after me, you had someone who scared him off, right?
That was just an act of compassion. And that contact is just someone I'm an asset to, that is all. She's not your way out the firing line. She would just be someone else to dodge a bullet for.
Would you be more inclined to share her details if I told you it wasn't just me in the firing line? If I don't get that money, he's coming after my family. Maybe even yours.
You know, gambling with your life is one thing, but gambling with your family is with my family. James, I know you have a problem. But how long am I supposed to sit around and wait until you realise that you have one?
The last time. Do not have
one. Of course you do. Listen to me, I had one. With drink, with drugs. Yours is with investments. Because that's how you see people, isn't it? As stocks that you can just pick up and ditch when you can't see the value anymore, when things become a little bit unstable for you.
How can you think that I place no value on you?
Because 48 hours ago, you were willing to fake your own death to get away from me.
And for that, I have said I'm sorry.
You're not sorry. You won't even tell me why you did it.
You'd be better off without me.
For once in your life, tell the truth. Why did you try and fake your own death?
Because I wanted out. Out of this house. Out of this village. Out of this entire life. Free from the stench of failure and the burden of love. I burnt my bridges. And I thought it was easier to cut and run than to stick around and mend them. I wanted to start again. And I wanted to do it alone.
Okay. Well, you know what the funny thing is? That's all you had to say. Goodbye, James. Well, when you enjoy that freedom. You know, I wanted to believe that Romeo was wrong when he said that you should have died last night, but I've just realised right now, he was wrong. Because you're already dead. You died the night Marnie did, and the saddest thing is, that's the way you always wanted it.
Sienna, it's James Nightingale. Yes. No, I'm calling on Steve's behalf, actually. He's lost his phone. No, well, he has one of mine now, but he asked me to get in touch because he needs the number of one of your clients. It's an important one, I think. Norma, that's the one. That's wonderful. Thank you.
Norma? It is Norma, isn't it?
James Nightingale, Steve's friend. Like I said on the phone, I think we can help one another.
Hang on a minute. Look, we can talk about this.
Help! Help!
What has Steve told you about me? And I want the truth.
No, nothing. All I know I learned organically, which is that dropping your name saved him from a rather overzealous debtor. That's why I got in touch. I have the same problem. Gambling debts. So rest assured, Steve steadfastly refused to give me your number.
Just as well that's a good fit for you, James Nightingale. I have a feeling you're going to be in there for quite a while.
If this is your way of showing me you're not a woman to be trifled with, rest assured I'm here to do no such thing. I wasn't overselling when I said we could help each other.
Oh, I'm afraid you won't be leaving with a loan. In fact, you're going to do very well to leave here at all.
Steve said you look after your assets. I can be one. Much more valuable than Steve could ever be.
Looks like you used to be somebody once.
My client's collars may have been whiter than white, but their deeds were anything but. Thanks to me, they're sitting in boardrooms, not prison. There's a talent for taking dirty money and keeping your hands clean. I think it's one you might be able to make use of. I've been asking for a long-term contract with pension and health benefits here. But if I'm half as good as I think I am, then you'll be onto a winner. And if not, then, well, as you say, you have one that fits.
All right, I'll pay off your debt. But first I have a job that needs doing. Tomorrow.
What kind of job? A case?
No, not yet. If you're keen to represent people in my business, I think it might be helpful to get some experience in the shop floor.
Well, I'm not some sort of petty...
You were right. The ability to keep clean hands in my business is a useful skill, but the willingness to get them dirty, well, that's essential. So tell me, James Nightingale, is that something you're prepared to do?